Welcome class, this is Professor Weathersby. In this video, we'll give a quick example of how to do variable length subnet masking, also called VLSM. VLSM problems will generally ask you one of the following five questions. How many subnets does the following network allow? How many hosts does it allow? What is a subnet ID? What is a usable IP address range? And finally, what is a broadcast ID? To begin, what I tend to do is I will write out the 8-bit binary place values that we'll be using to convert to binary. What I also tend to do is write out the powers of 2. Now, both these two steps are not exactly necessary. I do them as a way not to get confused and as a quick reference for when I'm doing many problems consecutively. Over time, you may find that you may not need to write these out, as you'll have these in your head. Now, you can keep writing. I tend to write up to about the power of 9 and the power of 10, as that's generally helpful for most problems. Now, in this particular IP address, we have a subnet mask of 255.255.255.192. Generally speaking, I find it's helpful to figure out how many bits we're going to be needing to, how many bits represent this particular subnet mask. Now, from class, we learned that each octet is represented by 8 bits, and when you use each 8 bits, you come up with a value of 255. So, as this first octet is 255, we know we're using all 8 bits. As the next value is 255, we also realize it's using all 8 bits. The next value is 255, we're using all 8 bits. Now we've come to a value that's not 255. In this case, we need to figure out how many bits we're going to need to come up with a value of 192. 128 plus 164 happens to be 192. If we were going to write this out in decimal notation, we could then fill in the remaining bits with zeros. Now, in this case, we're using 2 bits to represent 192. So we're going to write a 2 here. Now, I tend to write a slash to differentiate how many bits we're going to use between the host and the network. Now, given that each octet is represented by 8 bits, we're going to take 8 minus 2 to figure out how many remaining bits are in this octet. That value happens to be 6. Now, to figure out the number of networks that this subnet mask will allow, we take 2 to the power of the number of bits we're using on the network, this happens to be 2, to come up with a value. In this case, 4. Again, we have 2 to the power of 4 written here, so for quick reference. So we now know that this network ID, this subnet ID, will allow for 4 networks. Now, how many hosts are available per network? Well, we take 2 to the power of the number of bits that we're using for the host, which happens to be 6, minus 2. This minus 2 is used to subtract for the IP addresses that will be used for the subnet, the network ID, and for the broadcast ID. So 2 to the power of 6 minus 2 equals 64, minus 2 equals 62 hosts per network. Now, we're almost done. We've just answered 2 of these questions. How many subnets does it allow? 4. How many hosts does it allow per subnet? How many hosts does it allow per subnet, which is 62. So, to figure out the subnet ID and the usable address range and the broadcast ID, we do this final step, which is we take the subnet mask, 192, and we take 256 minus 192 to come up with an increment value. This value, 64, represents the total increments that the subnets will be separated by. What I tend to do is subtract 64 by itself to come up with 0, 64 plus itself to come up with 128, and you keep going until you've reached a value that encompasses the bits in question, in this case 83. So we're looking for a value that shows up, we're looking for an increment that encompasses 83, 120, 83 lies between 64 and 123, so we now know to stop. So from here, we take 1 minus 128 to come up with the previous subnet's broadcast ID. 127 represents a broadcast ID. The 64 in this case represents the subnet ID. And to come up with a usable address range, all we have to do is to figure out what values are between 64 and 127, which is very easy. 65 through 126 represents the usable IP range. And that's it. So we've just answered each of these questions. Let's write them out. How many subnets does this network allow? 4. Write it over here. How many hosts per subnet does it allow? 62 hosts. What is a subnet ID? A subnet ID in this case is 172.28.110.64, this value right here. What is the usable address range? Which is 172.28.110.65 through 126, and then finally, what is the broadcast ID? The broadcast ID in this case, again, we have it down here, is 172.28.110.127, and that's it. These generally represent the what most variable length subnet mask problems will generally ask you. I hope you enjoyed today's lesson. Look for additional lessons on variable length subnet masking and other topics from this class. Thank you.